computer program.
How much crap is on your phone?
A lot. Dude? She like this. Jeez. This is mine. I made that, dude. I made that, and I made this.
Can you loop it?
Yeah. Not on my phone.
You're way off beat on
that. I know. What do you think?
That's like a cheesy 80s movie.
I made that.
That's like boss music on Shinobi.
But I made that.
You didn't make it.
I did.
No, those loops are like Legos.
No, those are... I made every sound on there.
How?
I had
what program?
I'd have to look on my computer to find it, but it's been a long fucking time. But I still have a little program. There's a little piano program. And then there was another program that made... That's not mine. That. There's a program that you
oscillator.
could just make tones to where it does that, you know? And then... That's from a little piano program. I kid you not. These are all Bubba originals.
Why aren't you doing this, like...
Huh?
Why aren't you doing this?
Look at that. That's kind of cool, right?
I guess that's all right.
Every bit of that's mine, man. Wait. Huh?
It all sounds like video games.
Yes! I told you, this has been like...
years ago.
This is my 9-inch nails, Sam.
It makes me think of a bunch of floppy.
Wait, listen. You can hear where it loops. Did you see that?
And I forgot the bloggy.
Oh, this is my, that's my Knight Rider thing. Huh?
Wait. Like, Kit Knight Rider?
Well, I was trying to.
Or, what is the Knight Rider from Mad Max? That's way busy.
I know. I think. It's a little drum program I had.
I feel like you created dubstep long before dubstep was a thing. That
went
not that good.
Oh, wow. Thank you.
What was Muffin Man?
Some friends of mine. These are ringtones I made. There's another one. I'll let you hear that.
God, there's so much.
Well, dude, it's because I have a boring life. This is my friend Eric Gwynn came over, and me and him both made this. Okay? Huh?
It's like... Ooh, yeah.
That's what we were doing.
Really?
That's his ringtone now.
That's ridiculous.
That's awesome, right?
It gets all right.
You can use these if you want.
I don't want them.
What?
I better turn my phone off.
What's wrong with that? That's awesome, right?
It's like weird Metroid music. Super Metroid, the good one.
Huh?
That's terrible.
Alright, that's awesome. Whenever we're ready, I'll start doing this.
No, we are ready. This is all on. You never... Once the camera's set up, I assume it's always going.
I'm so sweaty.
I don't want to touch it.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you're gonna need a potato.
A potato?
Yeah.
Just turn the switch off. I'll give me a pair of pliers. I'll get it. Switch is off.
Hi, welcome to Bubba Loves Ed.
We're on Bubba Loves Ed.
You're going to get salt in your eyes and it's going to burn. You look like a member of U2.
On the edge.
I'm from a world where we have chips for eyes.
So, last week's episode was a lot of fun, and we got some feedback from our good friend Mike. So we're going to answer his questions and comment on his comments.
Mike Parton from Strange Fellows and Introvert Party.
Yeah.
Still got to go over more?
Yeah, come on. Scoop.
Get
up in me.
Do you want to spank me?
Would you want to spank me with meat? Meat. All right, so number one. I really like this episode. Maybe my favorite that I have watched.
Mike's watched them all.
Even he likes it more than the one he was on. I felt like that was a really good episode.
Who?
Well, the first one he was on. That was a really good episode. The second one he was on would have been better, but Dalton ruined it with his...
Yeah, look at that.
Look at that.
Look at that. I got a phone.
Look at me. Thank you, Mike. We appreciate it.
I do appreciate it, Mike.
Number two, and this is for you. Why does no one remember poor Scott? Damn you, Bubba.
I said that I have not had a lot of interaction with Scott. I'm sorry, Scott. You're a fine percussionist.
What's his last name?
Strange fella. Scott Strange fella.
I'm not going to say his actual name on YouTube, because I feel like that would betray his trust.
Yeah, maybe Scott's not his real name.
Maybe, I don't know.
I'd like to point out that the Dead Milkmen have a song called Watching Scotty Die.
That's a really good song.
It is.
Number three. My dad also really liked Transylvania.
Why wouldn't he? I'm a little bit bummed because I didn't go see them this weekend.
Trent, he's sorry, I'm sure.
I'm very sorry, Trent, because I really wanted to go, but it's a money thing.
No, it wasn't. You were at my birthday barbecue bash.
No, that wasn't that night. Well, that night was the Bottle Breakers who broke down in Kansas City and could not perform in Springfield.
Oh, yeah.
If you ain't watching Bo Loves Ed, you're not watching nothing.
I only have room for two vegans at my house. They were there. They ate all the mushroom caps.
None.
Good. You should like Transylvania. Am I right?
No reason you shouldn't like Transylvania. They're fucking badass.
Yeah. Does your mom like Transylvania?
Does your mom even like you?
I'm winking. You know what that means. Four. Thanks for talking about the tape.
The tape. The
Sistro.
Sistro?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's saving me one.
Thank you.
Which is awesome.
We like to help out local people.
Yes. And after hearing how... hate saying this, how your album's coming out, what I heard on your phone. Michael did a really good job.
He did do a really good job.
Let's just see how it goes on to cassette.
Oh, it'll sound good. Five, that bar in Joplin was weird and the lights were amazing. Nothing but agreement there. Six, Bubba. As I said, you can still get the effing Flexi deal, so shut up! Exclamation point.
If the deal is, I can have the other colors, you know, so you just don't pin them up on your wall or something later. It'd be cool.
Hey, thanks for putting Captain Diabetes, who I believe is you, in his place.
And what is... Okay, if I'm Captain Diabetes, who is Mike now?
He is Sergeant Asthma.
Is Sergeant Asthma and Captain Diabetes?
Yeah. Well, actually, he might be like Brigadier General Asthma, because I don't want you to be a higher rank than him.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Which brings to mind the Facebook soulmate quiz that you said, the best thing about this quiz is that nobody's got Stanley. And that, actually, when I posted that, like, oh, I guess... Bubba loves Ed, but Ed loves Teresa more. Hashtag.
You put the hashtag in the wrong place.
Just now, but I didn't on there. It really actually, that actually made me feel very, very, very sad.
I knew it would, too, when I posted. I was like, oh, he's going to be all
sad. I mean,
sad.
Like, really sad because
You know? You literally post 20 videos on my wall a week. Straight to me. Not
yeah,
just
no.
like...
I know. Dude, I thought that's what friends do. But nobody really ever shares anything with
All me. Right. Number 9. Why are you so mean to Led Zeppelin?
Because of US 97.
They ruined it. They ruined a lot of music.
And I hate it because Led Zeppelin's a fine band. AC/DC, you know, I've liked all these bands, Van Halen, Aerosmith, classic rock, the Beatles. but US 97 has a tendency to play the same songs over and over and over and over and over by the same bands.
Yeah.
There is new music out there. I know they're a classic rock station, but they're playing Nirvana and Pearl Jam and Poison and Motley Crue. And me, classic rock is like this kind of rock, this era. That's classic. Buddy Holly, Elvis, classic rock.
Classic rock!
I think that's just weird, and it just makes me feel old.
Aww.
And if I have to hear another...
Alright, this one is kind of for Rozhawk. This is number 10. I think Rozhawk, did I spell that right? Sure you did. Should keep a tally of everything you guys screw up during a podcast and tell you how many mistakes you made and correct those mistakes. One, he kind of already does that. We get yelled at for a good 4 hours before we start filming.
We've been at his house at 6 o'clock this morning. It's now like 9:30 at night. I've already been made to cry twice and I've slit my wrists once.
God, you're spitting chip crumbs all over the place.
And I spit chip crumbs all over
the place.
Oh, look, a badger.
And number 11.
Badger now, though.
Remember, none of this matters, and I only did this because I'm really bored at work. Well, guess what? We only did this because we're really bored at our own podcast.
I'm not bored. I drive over an hour to come up here. I'm sorry that it bores you, Ed.
Well, hanging out with you is a bummer.
That's what everybody tells me. It's cool. Do they have an app for suicide on your phone?
It's a suicide box, like from Futurama.
I'm the man in the suicide box.
All right, and we just hung out with Mike yesterday. I had a belated birthday party that I invited a bunch of people to, and only like 7 showed up. And
if you don't remember being there, apparently you weren't invited.
There's always next year. Try to be my friend more. I don't know. I invited people through Facebook, and if you're not on Facebook, you don't get an invite. And I'm sorry. I made the event page. It was awesome. And I had a picture of fat me grilling. That picture was like fat. But anyway.
The mushroom caps were amazing. And the beef or the pork was awesome.
Dude, that pork is so good. I made tacos out of it today.
I can't wait. Pretty good.
Yeah.
The leftovers you gave me. Oh, I forgot your Tupperware.
Did you bring the, that salad?
No.
Who brought that?
I don't know.
Because it's in some awesome Tupperware and I don't want to give it back.
Oh, what salad was it? No, I didn't bring the salad. No, I just didn't.
It was a pasta salad.
Pasta salad.
Maybe Kimber brought that.
I don't know.
You're not getting it back because I love that Tupperware. But when you were leaving and I loaded you down with pork.
Yeah, we ate it on the way home. Monique and Izzy were just like eating it, driving down the road.
That's what I was doing when I was real drunk in the kitchen by myself. I'm just like,
it was really good.
You told me to look up TheBeatlesNeverBrokeUp.com.
The Beatles.
And basically it's a story about how this guy was chased, like, on his way home. His dog had to go to the bathroom. He pulled over, let him out. Dog ran off after a rabbit. He took off running after his dog. He tripped in a rabbit hole.
This was in California.
Yeah. Knocked himself out, and he woke up in a weird place.
Yes.
It was like a normal room house, but there were like weird electronics he didn't recognize in there, and some guy named Jonas, and I think the Weezer song Jonas might be after, like, about it.
It might be. Never thought of that. Never thought it might be.
Yeah.
And the ketchup was purple, he stated.
Yeah. But he was in an alternate dimension, and they talked about music, and got to the Beatles, who that guy said his brother had just went to their latest show.
This was sometime in the 2009 is when this happened.
Yeah. And And he's like, oh, well, the Beatles from my time era broke up a long time ago. So he let him listen to a bunch of tapes, because tapes were still cool there. CDs never took up. Like, they never were like, yeah, CDs. So when the guy wasn't there, he snagged a tape.
It's a time ruled by Mike Pardon.
Yeah, like he grabbed a tape, stuffed it in his pocket, and came back to our time.
Because Jonas was a trans-dimensional tourist.
Yes.
That's how they go on their vacations, apparently.
Well, he was actually one of the guys, from what I read, that would go to other dimensions to see if they were okay for the tourists to go to.
Okay, yeah.
And basically saved the guy who went by Richards.
James Richards, which is
a made-up name. People have tried to find out who he really is, and they can't. But it's a really interesting story.
And you can debunk it all you want, but there's still...
Yeah, like all of the music, it's the Beatles album that he brought back is called Everyday Chemistry. Look it up on YouTube and listen to it, and it's weird because it's like parts of music done by the post-Beatles. Yeah, it's crazy. But it's not exactly, like some of them are in minor chords when the real ones are in major chords.
Here's a quote.
It's like the Beatles if Trent Reznor had been like the producer.
Yeah, this is a quote from Mr. Richards here. When asked that the songs sounded like songs from the Beatles' solo eras.
Yeah.
Says, I had a feeling some of the songs had a familiar sound to them as well. The only conclusion I can come up with is even though in the alternative universe, the Beatles hadn't broke up, it didn't mean their future music ideas disappeared.
Makes sense.
Makes perfect sense. And only the strongest of the ideas would have survived between the four Beatles making a song.
Yeah. So you would lose some choruses from the songs, and you would like...
Yeah.
One of the songs I remember was like from Cold Turkey, because I downloaded an app on my phone just to like hold it up and hear the song and try to locate what it was. So I could go to that song on YouTube and listen to it while listening to the one from the alternate
dimension. You were really on that last night, weren't you?
I was obsessed. Like, I was dozing off and stuff around midnight, and I was like, I've got to go to bed. This is so interesting, but I've got to go to bed. I love stuff like this. I love science fiction. Even if it's not real, it's an awesome story, and it sounds like something like Robert Heinlein would write.
We've got a movie idea, anybody. They can make a good movie.
We'll basically take any director but Sam, because we want this to be a Hollywood blockbuster, not a Springfield, Missouri blockbuster. We just want a bigger budget, Sam. It's not no slashers. It's not going to be a slasher flick.
No.
It's going to be a sci-fi movie. Way better than Jupiter Ascending.
Way better than The Last Temptation of Christ.
Way better than... No, it probably won't be better than that one.
Which one?
Princess Bride.
It can't be better than Princess
Bride.
Yeah,
it really probably can't be unless we can get Cary Elwes... to star in it.
That'd be cool. He could play me.
He could play Jonas! His name is Jonas!
He has a phonus.
Carrying the world.
Nice try.
But it's just a really weird story, and I got obsessed, and I still am. I want to cover one of the songs with a T, and I think I will.
Well, it's going to be awesome, and we're going to make a movie about it. We just don't know how yet. We'll talk to Lloyd Kaufman.
Cameras. We'll need cameras for sure.
Nah.
Yeah.
Cameras right here.
That shooting MOV.
No. We've got some that shoot not an MOV. And
all right.
There was a local film in Springfield that a guy used.
What was the name of that one?
I'm not going to say the name of the film.
This delicious ice cold come and go drink is so good. Give us money.
I feel the same way about Casey's. My first child was conceived in Casey's.
Poke a hole in it.
Blast the bottom out of it.
Pow!
That's what she said.
But it's a really good album. It's actually a good album.
It's really cool, actually. Yeah. I downloaded it on my phone. You can download it anywhere. Just Google Beatles Never Broke Up or Beatles
It's BeatlesNeverBrokeUp.com.
Can
just go there.
You can see it's still a live website?
Yeah, that is still a live website. The other one was weird. It just kept saying June26.com.
Yeah, weird.
Or it was like JUN26.com.
Yeah, I don't like plugging the Beatles because it's the monkeys rule.
Monkeys!
But that's fine. But it's really awesome.
Yeah, to check it out.
So
I'd go there right now. It's a lot better than the weird videos you keep posting on my shit. You want to spank me?
You want to
spank? God.
You want to spank me with some meat?
Anyway, next party I have is going to be a pool party.
Pool party. Clothing optional.
I am actually maintaining my downstairs area.
Do you know 43 bacteria, an average of 43 bacteria live on the human penis? If you're circumcised, it's a few less.
So you have a few less and I have a few more.
That's right.
No, I'm keeping everything downstairs in shape for when I buy a Speedo.
You're going to buy a Speedo?
It's my backyard. It's my pool. I do what I want.
Weird. I pee off my porch at home towards the traffic. I've had to since the septic backed up this week, so...
Do you just hang your ass off and shit, too?
No. We drive up to the convenience store.
How convenient!
Yep.
We saw Red Kate. You rode with us.
Red Kate.
To see them in Joplin. That was a lot of fun. My God. They're so good.
Yes, they are. Red Kate. C-Rex. With a T.
With a T. Not many people there, but man, it's still fun.
It's the Blackthorn. It's always fun.
Free pizza. That's all I care about.
It was good. It was good. Vegetarian pizza.
I think after this barbecue, I might be going vegetarian.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
It kind of hinged on the way to Joplin, we saw that tractor trailer full of turkeys.
Really? That really messed with you that bad?
Yeah. Then on the way back, we saw that same tractor trailer
with no turkeys.
All of the cages were empty.
So it really hurt your feelings when I yelled out the window to the turkeys when we drove by. See you Thanksgiving, you yummy turkeys!
No, it's,
You probably were like, I hate you, Bubba. I'm glad you're crippled and fat.
No, it's the fact that that cage was their world. And it makes me sad. Like, if it was free-range turkey running around doing what turkeys do,
how do you know that cage was their world? They live in a big turkey house.
No, they...
Yes, have you not ever been to the turkey farms?
Yeah, it's nothing but like small things of turkeys as far as the eye can see.
They don't need to go anywhere, they're going to be eaten.
They deserve to do what turkeys do.
And what is that? Grow up to be eaten.
Yeah, but to enjoy life in the sun and eat bugs and stuff. And
What? They're raised to be eaten.
Listen, I'm going to go vegetarian, but there's going to be one stipulation. One, I got to eat fish. Because I love
that's
fish.
What about the fish? Don't they deserve to live?
Yeah, they do, because I've caught all my fish from the wild growing up. Like, I am from a fishing family.
Okay, so...
We didn't barbecue when I was a kid. We had fish fries.
So, wait. So, it's okay to yank a wild animal out of its home that it's happy living in and eat them.
Yeah.
How would you like it if you went home and somebody was standing outside your house...
God's going to eat me when I die!
...had a fishing pole thrown into your house... And had Amber hooked, and they were reeling her out, and she's like fighting, flopping around, and they reel her out, and they're like, oh, I'm taking pictures with her, and then fillet her and throw her on a fire to eat her.
I found a new wife.
Oh, okay. with that, I guess we'll be right back after these messages
from our spot.
We actually talked about things that we were having in little slips of paper that had.
Just one.
Just one?
Just one.
Just one.
So if you pull that, we have to talk about it again. And it's going to be real dumb.
No, I'm going to talk about it in an alternate universe.
This is a new segment called The Hat. All right. You want to do it? I wrote them all down, so you do it. We're just going to keep adding to this every week, too.
Are you serious? You put that one in there.
Read it out loud. Yeah.
This is what we got yelled at for earlier.
I don't care.
This is the type of thing that we got in trouble about earlier.
Then use the proper terminology for it.
That's not how you wrote it down. This was a conversation me and Ed were having at his house.
I've had this conversation a lot, too, the past, like, month.
Which is weird, because this is what his birthday turned into, a conversation everybody had. The conversation was, how much money would it take to suck a dick? Ed's price is a little higher than mine.
Yeah, $500. I'm not going to say it's going to be good, but $500 is all it would take for me to do that. Now, for 10 grand, which is a life-changing amount of money for, like, most people.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
No,
for me, it would be.
No, it would not.
I'm talking, you would get a little prostate play.
I'm trying to tell you, 10 grand is not a life-changing amount of money for anybody.
For me, it is.
No, it would not be.
Yeah, I could pay off my van.
Please send inquiries to ed@bubbalovesdead.com.
Not that I condone prostitution when it's illegal,
but if it
was legal.
Paying off your van, that'd be great. It is not life-changing.
Yeah, it is. That's one payment I don't have to worry about.
No, that's awesome, but it is not life. You have to trust me on this.
All right.
You have to trust me on this. $314,000 was not life-changing.
You own a house.
I do own a house, and I own cars.
Yeah.
But I would have still owned a house and cars. I would have just been
not
paying for them.
Yeah. Yeah,
I mean, I'm telling you, it's not. It takes way more money than what you. It's not life changing.
All right, but if you really want me to do some good fellatio, 10 grand.
10 grand.
All right.
10 grand.
And I know what yours is. It's your answer to like everything.
Why $50 in a Pepsi?
Yeah. Why a Pepsi?
Get the taste out of my mouth.
Coke doesn't do the job.
Because if I'm gonna pay somebody to be sucking on my dick and.
Fellatio.
I'm not going to take a shower for a couple days.
The fellatio, that sounds like a place I would play at in, like, California.
The fellatio.
Oh, I'm playing the fellatio tonight down on Rodeo Drive.
Welcome to the fellatio. Tonight we have with a tea.
You want to spank me? I didn't hear any of the other answers.
Well, the other answers were stuff like it got into how big everybody's deck was.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry, but mine...
Backyard decks.
Big decks, yeah. Everybody's, yeah. Your deck was real slippery. But you had a slippery deck.
Because it rained!
And I had to point out to everybody that since the accident, the only way that my wife is satisfied with a deck is that we have two decks.
Yeah.
Always have to have the stunt deck.
By the way, that foggy notion from Mother's, that stuff was like 10%, and it rocked me. I now understand where Amber was at.
Thursday
night. Yeah. Amber got...
She got chocolate wasted.
Dude. She was like... Oh, I haven't seen her like that in a while.
She got Dalton drunk. She got Dalton so bad. I thought you were going to be like, you don't talk about my wife like that. Wait, you are my wife.
Yeah. It happens.
Dalton's never going to see this, so it doesn't matter.
He might.
Really?
Downtime at the shop.
Really? You think he'd actually?
Downtime where he tattoos at the shop in Independence, Missouri. Island Tattoo. You owe us money. We mentioned you.
But if you're here or in Branson and want to go get a tattoo, you need to go to Buckle Up Tattoo.
Buckle Up!
John's a good guy, and there's other people there that I can't remember their names.
But John is the one you want to talk to.
He's got such beautiful blue eyes. He paints brains, too.
Yeah. Tell him Ed will do it for $500, and Bubba will do it for $50 and a Pepsi.
Word.
RC Ted. Cola. I would do an RC Cola. Is it my turn?
It's your turn.
God, I don't want to get a dumb one. It's raining.
One day it started raining. Yes!
White trash Walmart.
White trash Walmart. White trash Walmart. How many people have seen the video of the two ladies having a slight disagreement in Walmart with the shampoo the little kid was trying to hand them?
Listen, I have no problem with the ladies. It's that little kid.
That little kid.
That little kid, I want to pick him up and throw him.
Okay. You can't tell me what to do, bitch!
Yes!
I'm sorry, but they were both relatively not fat. The one that was the not fatter of the two...
The one that wasn't in the...
No, the one that was on the cart.
Okay.
That, jumps off and running, charges the lady. I'm curious to know what started the fight. And if somebody could post more videos on stuff like that, because I piggyback our videos on those.
Could I guess what started that fight?
Yes, please.
An ex-boyfriend that's probably banging one of them, and the other one's all like, "That's my man." If I had to guess, that would be it.
Yeah. If you have any comments, please leave them on BubbaLoveSet.com, or if you want to make our own white trash video like that to get 22 million hits in less than 24 hours, let's work something out. We'll make it real.
Why do you know those numbers?
Because I check. Because I piggyback our videos off of those. Because I post things like, if you think those women are crazy, check out how white trash these two dudes are.
Well, even outside of that, like before that video, there's always been people of Walmart.
Yes.
And it's just disturbing what people will wear in there. Disturbing.
I've promised people that if they wanted to dress up and go to Walmart and shop, that I would dress up too.
God's angry at us, Stanley. It's storming.
Scary. We gotta go. I think something's happening outside. Really? I'm gonna pick up on Commercial Street on the way home, you know what I'm saying?
Careful. From what I hear, someone has a gun down there on Commercial Street.
Blah!
Wait. You want to draw another one?
You want to draw another one?
Let's do it. Let's draw one more, and that'll be all of the hat, and we'll save the rest of them in there and add to it.
I am Nick, the emperor of all the teenagers of the world, and I love Bubba Loves Ed.
Oh, that's a good one.
What did you score on your first driver's test?
Yeah. The driving part.
I don't remember, but it took me 3 times to pass the written and 3 times to pass the driving.
Took me 3 times to pass the written, and my driving one, I scored the lowest possible score you could get and still pass, which was a 70. And the guy that was like driving with me, riding, he told me that in like this serious, like, you have got the lowest score you can get and still pass. Like he didn't want to pass me. It's like, well, you have to, because that's the law. Because I did all kinds of dumb things, like, yeah. It was in Rolla, too, so it really didn't even matter. But I passed.
Well, when they took you on the driving test in Rolla, did you go past the pig brothel?
That's not even a real thing. The Weekly World News is not hip to what's going on in Rolla. Yes, we did.
Feel like a pig.
It felt good. You don't remember what you scored.
No, I don't remember at all.
It wasn't exciting. You weren't all like, yeah!
No. I was just glad I passed. Yeah, much like high school. I have no idea how I passed
high school. Oh, show off.
Right. Took me 3 times.
You made it, though.
I made it. My buddy who taught me how to drive, because my dad wouldn't. He drove with me once. But he had a blue Ford Escort. I would drive him around. He would let me drive every time we went somewhere. And if I made a mistake, he had a Donatello, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle, the stuffed animal with the big plastic eyes.
Yeah.
Every time I made a mistake, he'd grab it by the feet and start hitting me in the head with it while driving. Yes.
Man, that got you ready for kids, huh?
Oh, my God.
You need to use your dressing!
I'll tell you what. I got good.
My dad, I went from trying to learn how to drive a regular, like, standard to, like, or an automatic. Oh. To a standard.
I tried to drive Monique's bug the other day, and she was sleeping. She woke up and came out there and had to move it for me because I can't coordinate my feet anymore.
No.
I learned how to drive a stick on a...
God, I wish we had that footage of you riding that bike and how you just got off. You just fell.
I didn't know how else to get off.
That was my fault. He already had it recording, and I thought he didn't have it recording, so I hid.
I had a video of me on my phone getting #BubbaLovesEd tattooed, and I made it a good video, too. And I was transferring to my computer, and something happened and it stopped transferring and the video never got to the computer. Ooh, wasn't ooh. On the phone anymore.
Show your mop blooded. Mop blooded! Applesauce blood.
Oh. Those were tattooed on me by my buddy Jay Boss at Riggs Monster Tattoo.
Jay Boss! Who also knows our friend Steve.
He wrecked her.
Don't say their last names.
The reach-arounds, I'm sorry. You can buy the fucking
album. I don't know why I don't want him to say their last names, but I swear to God, if you stalk these people, whoever's watching this, Mike, maybe Sam, I doubt it.
Sam, if you're masturbating watching this, I'm going to be so pissed.
Why? He should do a live cast of him cranking one out while he watches this.
Dude, I'll Skype with him.
Dude.
Except without a screen, I could be holding my wife's boob.
I wish we
that had, way it's not.
I wish we had a picture of Sam right now in some like face of ecstasy behind us,
or maybe,
or pain.
wearing makeup, sucking on someone's fake boob at a Halloween party.
There's no way we'd ever find something like
there's
that.
There's no way anybody has a picture like that.
If only there was a way
that it could come up behind us. Wonder how.
Oh, that's probably going to happen.
I don't know.
So I shot a bunch of footage on the bloggy and forgot it at home.
Footage of what?
Drunk Punk Mondays last week.
Oh, I'd like to see that. I heard there was some interesting things happening.
The reach around, or not the reach arounds, the results. Mm-hmm. That's all you need to know. I love the results. Amy, Dale, you guys... You guys are part of my music family, and I love you.
I would pay some big money to see him.
How much? You should have been here, but you had to come Thursday so you could drive with us.
And my septic backed up into my basement Wednesday night.
Oh, that's so gross.
While we were trying to fix the toilet downstairs because it was leaking. And we noticed that when you flush the toilet...
It was just leaking water?
Yes, out of the back, the innards of the tank.
Where was the poop water coming from?
I mean, the shower. The shower. And we were trying to fix that. And then we flushed the toilet, and water started coming out of the shower. And we're like, oh, shit, literally. And I found out our septic was full. And... After I tried to plunge, like, oh, we got something clogged. I tried to plunge it.
Do the plungy thing again.
I was plunging it. And when I was plunging it, the tremendous suction blew the fucking wax ring out of the toilet. And so now our friend Tony, who's a great, awesome plumber, been a plumber for a very long time, is coming over to fix it.
You know who else is a great plumber?
Mario.
Mo from Scene of Irony.
Really?
Yeah.
She's a good plumber.
Really good plumber.
Really good plumber.
Really good plumber.
I would really like to have another house guest one day.
Me too.
Get it in there.
Oh. I feel weird in the downstairs area right now.
See, Bubble Up's head.
Like my testicles are all... I'm turning into a woman. Just like Donnie and his sister.
Marie.
Yeah. I think it's one person and they just like...
That might be.
Flip-flop genitals.
You remind me of Chaz Bono.
Thank you. He is rich and you are not.
Yeah.
So, wait, I do?
Yeah.
You look like him.
No. No. What?
You look like the bass player for Buddy Holly. The movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It's fact.
Every day?
Yeah. If a picture of him could pop up behind us, I'm sure... Everyone would agree.
So I look like the bass player for Buddy Holly from the movie?
Yeah.
I look like that every day.
Yeah.
That'll be the day when I
do. You shut up.
So, let's see.
Oh,
what's coming up? What's coming up now? What's coming up
this week?
Man, there's not a whole lot going on this week, is there?
There really isn't. I'm sure there is, but I disconnected my phone to the Facebook thing, so.
Why?
I don't know.
I guess because we're taking a break.
Hello.
Hi.
We're back with upcoming events in the Springfield area. Today, the 9-year anniversary of the Stepchild. Just joking. That got canceled. Kitty's going to be here tomorrow. That got canceled.
Is that the 15th? Oh, it's the 4th. Yeah, tomorrow. Yeah, they got the Kitty show got canceled because their visas. They couldn't get their visas.
Where are they from?
They're like from Canada, eh?
Really? We can't get Canadian people visas?
Well, like they probably did. Somebody did something bad or something.
That's stupid.
Like they spit on the Pope or something. Because I was going to go see freaking Kitty.
Meh.
They're like a 90s metal band, that you know, new metal, that was really awesome.
Meh.
First time I saw them, they were like 15.
Meh.
It was weird. I didn't go up and talk to them, get their autographs, because it was like, that'd be creepy.
Eh.
I would now, though, because Kitty's pretty cool.
Eh.
Then we have,
the very best of South Africa. I seen these guys playing Austin, Texas.
Who is it? The very best of South
Africa. Oh, the very best, South Africa, long weird word, gigantic, and Boo Rad.
That's Boo Rad, not the Boo Radleys, because I like the Boo Radleys.
Yeah. And that's going to be, what, Front of House Lounge?
Yes, at 9 o'clock.
Actually, anything that you see that says Johan Presents is Front of House Lounge.
Okay. Then we have, here we go.
Ooh, The Fine Lines.
Friday, June 19th.
Boom. With Heart Punch and a couple bands from Wisconsin.
The Rashida Joneses and Filter Free Rodeo.
I keep wanting to say Radio.
I do want to see Radio because I like... There's a really great, bad 80s song by Roger Waters called Radio Waves.
I love it. Well, you said it's real bad, but you love it.
It's Roger Waters.
Man, that's cool, I guess. Right?
I'm loving Radio Waves.
That's way later in June, dude.
That's June 22nd, Honky Suckle with Every Man downstairs at
Front House Lounge.
Front House Lounge.
Because Johan Presents.
It's, but it's, you know, Every Man.
Is it just called Every Man?
It looks like Every Man from Lake Worth, Florida.
I like that they have that in their little, well, so does Honky Suckle.
Yeah, see?
Huh.
Good bands put where they're from.
I'm from Earth.
That's cool. Now, if you're going to be in Fort Worth, Texas on the 27th...
This is a show worth driving for.
I don't know the first two bands, the Dangits and One Fingered Fist, but those sound like badass band names. And the Strange Fellas.
Our good friend Mike, Bill, and
Scott.
The other guys.
I said Scott. I've got a friend, his name is Scott. He's in Strange Fellas, and he gets left out a lot.
Hey, you made a rhyme! I'm proud of you!
Sorry, Scott.
But yeah, that's Fort Worth.
Fort Worth at Aussie Rabbit Lodge.
And Michael Parton is going.
Michael Parton has to go because he...
He doesn't have to.
Well, he plays the ukulele.
Amber didn't go with me to Houston.
That's weird. How'd you play the...
Play our songs?
Yeah.
Mm. I just did stuff. Don't worry about it. Magic.
Weird.
Magic the Gathering.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Your boy plays that.
My boy plays with a lot of things. Don't put no thoughts of heaven.
Star Baby!
Don't put no thoughts of heaven in your head.
All right, we're about to call out Joyce Jones. And why? Why are we calling out your mom?
Well, she was supposed to have us cookies this week.
I don't see any cookies.
I don't see any cookies either, so we're going to call my mom right now.
That's bullshit.
Although, just, we're going to start calling random people.
Oh, God, Joyce.
Are you serious? Oh, we're going to wait. Her phone's off. My mother's phone is off.
Because she hates you.
Why did she turn... She turned it off on purpose.
Maybe she's getting the old dang diddly from the old dad.
Your dad?
Your dad.
Oh.
She's not going to pick up. She knows. She knows! I want my goddamn cookies!
This is bullshit, Mom. I should turn it around. I should give out her phone number.
Don't.
I know, I got my computer confiscated once for doing things by the Branson Police Department. They kept my computer for 6 months. They sure did.
Well, she's not going to answer, so...
No, she's not.
That's bullshit.
That's bullshit. I should call where she works.
Is she at work?
She might be at work. Look her up on Facebook, Joyce Jones.
Ask her where the... Oh, God, I want some cookies so bad.
This really makes me mad.
Hot, chewy,
How am I supposed to have my diabetes? I'm done. I'm done.
Those
I'm
are vegan cookies. You can't fool me.
Vegan cookies?
I miss the ovum of chickens in there. The delicious ovum.
Really? Like the turkeys we saw on that truck? Chickens are raised the same way, prick.
I didn't see a boatload of chickens.
Oh my God, you're such a wuss. I would have pulled that truck over and ate every one of them turkeys in those cages.
Oh my God.
Feathers and all.
You would have been all like...
It'd been like... like that. So.
No. Well, so your mom sucks.
Well, I mean, she's been married to... I mean, my dad hasn't left her or anything, so I suppose occasionally.
Well, no, not like that. That's disturbing. She basically ruined our last bit.
Yeah, ruined it.
She didn't make us cookies.
Didn't make us cookies at all. Thanks, Mom. What happens if I wreck on the way home and die?
Because never get your blood cookies. Sugar levels bottoming out.
Yeah, it's going to get below 700 soon.
Pancreatic shock my ass.
I don't even need a phone anymore. I don't care.
Well, I say we call it.
We call. We got. I don't understand. What are we doing? What?
The end of the show. He wants to pull something out of my butt?
I think he wants to pull something out of the hat and talk about it. No, I could, dude, you.
Oh, man. Oh, God, I hope I pull out the thing
no.
we already talked
God,
about.
No, God, no, and I hope you don't pull out the other thing that... No, we already talked about that one thing I told you I didn't want to talk about.
What is the dumbest drug that isn't really a drug you've done?
I don't understand the question. The dumbest drug that really isn't a drug?
Yeah. Like, say, sniffing modeling paint, or taking a bunch of Dramamine, or...
This one time, I took 52 mini-thins in about a three-hour period.
Oh my God.
And then I ate two of those 357 Magnums that were the high-caffeine thing. I was with a buddy who remained nameless, because I dated his sister in high school, and it was just kind of a hang-arounder. I was... 17.
That's the kind of like you can catch stuff that's falling and you don't even realize it's falling. Your body's just reacting.
Yes. I pulled over on the side of the road and this kid who was with me, why his mom trusted him to be with me. I'm like, dude, you have to drive. I can no longer drive. I don't want to drive. I feel like driving is taking too much of my time. Will you drive? It was the most horrible experience. I wanted to throw up.
Yeah.
But I couldn't. Then when I got home, I'm laying in bed going, well, maybe I am asleep. Maybe my eyes are closed. Hey, am I asleep? Are you asleep? Hey. It was horrible. And the next day, when I went to work at 5:30 in the morning to cook breakfast buffets and then cook on the grill, oh my God, the smell of cooking eggs and hash browns and greasy bacon. It was so horrible. That was one of the last times I ever took mini things. Remember mini things? You know?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, my, the major hair crawl.
Yeah.
I thought it was great because came up here to art, the art fest. Art Walk? No. Art Fest? Art Fest down on Walnut?
Yes.
Yeah.
And me and one of my buddies, you know, took, I don't know, 20 or so many things, and went walking on Art Fest, and we were just kind of like, oh, everything's this is cool. You know, it was...
The air feels so good on us.
Yeah. Yeah, and so I think I was probably, you know, sad about my life the night I decided I'll just take some more. And I was the first time I ever drove around with I dumped out half of a gallon of orange juice, and I put a pint of vodka in it, and I was...
I'm so cool. No one will ever catch me doing this.
Yeah. Yeah. So it was a really bad combination of things, and that was probably the dumbest. The second dumbest thing I did was that red pepper from you get to put on your pizza.
Yeah, crushed red pepper.
Yeah, dude at work took it, smashed it up even more, and took a little razor knife and chopped it up, and told me he'd give me $5 if I'd snort a line of it like that big. And I'm like, oh, not a problem. Like, for 2 days, that's all. I mean, it's like blisters in my nose. And I'm like, oh, but I made $5.
Oh, my God, that is horrible. Yeah. All right, you know how... All right, mine is really dumb. Really, really dumb.
Dumber than mine?
Yes. You know how you get... Many things would give you the scalp crawly,
uh-huh.
And you'd be like hot but sweaty, or like cold but sweaty, like cold sweats. I got that way from drinking way too much really old, super condensed coffee at my buddy's house. Because it had been sitting in a percolator for like 3 days with the percolator heat on. And it had just went from a full pot down to like a third into this black stuff that absorbed light. it was concentrated evil.
Was it strong?
Yeah, like drank it and instantly scalp started crawling, started getting the cold sweats, and I was just all like, oh my God.
Why'd you do that?
I don't know. In that same trailer, it was a trailer park in Rolla. One night, and I had no part in this, it's disturbing. My buddy's gerbil died. So, like, in front of them. It just died of old age or whatever.
Like, hey, God.
Yeah. They pretty much cleaned it, skinned it, cooked it, and ate it. Because they were on some powerful psychotropics. Yeah.
You're getting the meat sweats thinking about it.
Yeah, my buddy actually ate the gerbil brain. Like how you're just like, yeah.
I'm having the feeling that you had about those turkeys, about that gerbil right now.
Yes, yes. That's... And I wasn't there. I didn't condone it. If I was there, I would have stopped it, but I wasn't.
Well, it was their gerbil.
Yeah. At that time, I was living in Springfield, and I made a trip down there to visit some friends, and they're all like, man, you missed it last weekend. It's like, I really didn't miss anything after I heard the story.
I'm not even
going
to make any Richard Gere jokes about it.
And it was like, two of my friends lived there, and then the other friend who would always walk around the house naked because he just didn't care. Like, he didn't care. He'd walk around naked and, like, flop down and just start, like, touching himself inappropriately. Didn't care. Like, he did that in front of me. He did that in front of one of his roommates' moms.
What do you do then? What do you just like, hey?
You just ignore it. That's how he was and still is to this day. He's a weird dude. We went to a party once, me and Amber, later, when he lived in Springfield. Yeah, he lives up here now, in Aurora, actually.
Aurora.
But he lived in Springfield, and at that time, we were at a party. He went outside to take a leak and was peeing. Me and Amber were going to go pick someone up and bring them back because we hadn't been there but maybe a couple minutes. Like, we weren't loaded or anything. And he was peeing, and Amber asked him a question. He just turned around while he was peeing, and she looked down before she realized what she was looking at and was all like, oh, my God.
So, my God, that's a penis, and it's smaller.
Yeah. No, for real. It was like a weird mushroom patch, she said.
That's weird. I don't...
There's a lot of weirdos from where I'm at, too, and it's funny that I just now started remembering all these stories. It's all like, oh, you think Forsyth's bad? Well, in Rala...
I had a buddy that was staying at my house.
We're going to fucking story off. Do it!
Okay. Had a buddy who walked in when he was living with me, and this girl I was dating.
I'm taller than you.
And we were having sex, and he walked in on us, and I jumped up out of bed and chased him with a raging heart on out my front door, and he turned around and punched my dick.
I don't blame him. I'd do the same thing.
That's what I did.
Wait, did he punch it?
No, he...
Or did he... Punch it.
No. He punched it. Yeah, I went back inside.
Did you finish up, or were you all like, no, oh, I can't.
It's weird now. You know who you are, but you're not watching this podcast.
Where does he live now?
Same town.
Forsyth?
No.
Branson? Branson Hollister?
Hollister, yeah.
That's pretty much one big town.
Matter of fact, in the same place he probably lived, or his parents did, anyway.
I couldn't imagine punching a dude in the dick. But I threatened to do that to people.
Well, it was there, you know. He didn't like being chased by a dude with a raging boner.
I have threatened to punch people in the balls before at work because they were constantly showing them to people.
Batwing!
Yes.
It's the goat! Brains!
Right after that movie came out was the most horrible moment ever working in a restaurant. And I told him, I was like, listen, man, if I ever walk in and I see you doing that and you've tried to get me, I'm going to grab what you're grabbing and just start pounding it into nothing.
Just yank real hard.
And he's all like, ugh. I was like, I swear to you and all that is holy.
I got into a fight in middle school with a kid. And he actually knocked my ass down, and I reached up and grabbed his balls and yanked him down to the ground with him and beat his ass.
Do you know what that move is called?
And then I got teased. He said, oh, you wouldn't have won if you wouldn't have grabbed his balls. I'm like, that was the point in doing that particular...
Do you know what the actual name is of that move?
What?
It's called Monkey Steals the Peach.
Monkey Steals the Peach.
Yep. I had books on ninjutsu when I was in middle school.
That's awesome.
And, like, you're supposed to go down, and when you grab, you twist and pull down.
I didn't twist. I just grabbed and yanked.
Monkey Steals the Peach.
And you know what? I won. I won quickly. I only had to knock him in the head a couple times before he started crying.
And now that everybody knows that I know ninjutsu because I had a couple books in middle school, don't mess with me because I'm a ninja.
And I'm not afraid to grab
your
testicles.
Long before you, Timmy. Long before you.
And I'm not afraid to grab testicles and knock you down to the ground and keep beating you.
You just like to touch testicles.
It was over the pants.
Hey, two new messages. What? Your phone's lying face up.
One's from your mom.
No, my mom doesn't know how to Facebook on a phone.
She doesn't. She doesn't have to. She knows how to Craigslist. That's all I'm saying.
We need to read some more Craigslist stuff. We really do.
We need to put Craigslist ads on for both of us.
Why haven't we been using Craigslist to find
guests?
Oh!
Craigslist, we're coming for you.
Let me in, Stanley. Stanley, let me in.
No means no.
Hey, you know what would be awesome?
What?
If you would subscribe to this channel. Click the subscribe button.
Subscribe.
And if you didn't like this video, trust me, we have plenty more out there for you to go to and watch. You can like it.
Or you can dislike it. But if you dislike it, we'll come to your house.
And make sure if there's anything you want us to talk about, whether it's whatever.
Comments? Make a comment. Good comments, bad comments. Bad comments, we'll come to your house.
No, we won't.
Yes, we will.
He will, because he doesn't have a job. He's got a lot of free time.
Yeah, I've got a lot of free time. I do.
He's got several lists of people that he's going to...
That I'm going to click, I guess. We have Twitter. Follow us on Twitter. And Reason One Media.
Hey, do we have that Instagram yet?
No, I
don't have
the Instagram yet.
Hey, follow With the T-Band on Instagram.
Yes, if you like.
Shut up.
We have t-shirts. If you want a t-shirt, you could probably get a t-shirt.
Where at?
www.bubbalovezed.com.
Where are these magical things?
www.bubbalovezed.com. It's down, you click somewhere, and it's going to...
And it'll pop up, and there'll be this graph and a chart.
And then they'll be up there. And it's like the Matrix. You'll turn things, and then you'll move them like
Tom Cruise. There'll be a blue button and a red button.
And you push it.
And you take one of them.
And then you look for Reason One Media, and our friends at
Popeyes.
Your mom's
Bye!